Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? The autumn Milky Way rises like a pillar of light in the northeastern evening skies this week. Wait, what? You can't see it either? Well, that's where it should be seen. If we make 15 degrees hops from the 15 degrees per side, Great Square of Pegasus, through the second magnitude stars of Andromeda, we reach the second magnitude star of Murphak in Perseus the Hero. But who is this mythological character? Perseus was born of the god Zeus and the mortal Danae, and due to a rash promise had to secure the head of the Gorgon Medusa, who could turn men to stone if they looked at her. Using a polished shield, an adamantine sword given by Zeus, and the helmet of darkness from Hades, Perseus cut off her head, the body of which then turned into Pegasus, the flying horse. On his way back to Seriphus Island, Perseus also saved the princess Andromeda by slaying the sea monster Cetus. Murphak is of Arabic origin and means elbow. Is also known as Alpha Persei, likely designated as such due to it being the brightest star in the constellation. Conveniently, there's a rather large open cluster right around this star, known as the Alpha Persei Cluster. What makes it so wonderful to observe is that many of its members are in the 5th to 7th magnitude range, so even under city skies, it pops out easily into view. But the 3 degrees across size means that it's too large to see in most any telescope. So binoculars really are the best instrument with which to view this open cluster. Composed of many blue-white spectral class B stars, this is also in a dense area of the Milky Way. So with a bit of dark adaptation and screening of extraneous light, you can see many more of the 8th and 9th magnitude stars that are in the same line of sight. This cluster is just 580 light years away and is relatively young at 50 million years of age. And now this week's dark sky fact. Check this out. Here's a storefront location in a small city downtown area with well-shielded lighting that provides plenty of visibility for everyone and no uplighting. Aim or shield your lights down too and be an example for others in your neighborhood to do the same. Perseus has some other notable objects too. Looking north towards Cassiopeia, draw a line from Gamma and Delta Cassiopeiae back down in the direction of Murphak. About 7 degrees that direction is the double cluster, two open clusters right next to each other. These are easily seen with binoculars, but far better, and well framed, in a wide field telescopic view. At 7,500 light years away, they are quite a bit farther than the Alpha Persei cluster, but comparatively, they're just newborns in age, only about 13 million years old. Even so, with many stars in the 6th through 9th magnitude range, they are quite an impressive sight to see given the 1 degree across angular size. Use a moderately low magnification eyepiece for the best views. The moon reaches first quarter phase on October 11th, when observers in the US will get a look at the lunar X in the afternoon, and Western Europe gets a nice view of it in the late evening hours. Early in the week, the narrow waxing crescent moon says hi to Venus on the 7th, and an evening later moves east, bringing the star Antares into a nice grouping with them. For night owls, the king of the planets Jupiter clears the horizon by midnight or so late in the week, and not a moment too soon with Saturn dropping below the western horizon a few weeks ago at dusk. Mars trails behind by 3 hours or so, but makes up for it by scooting close by the first magnitude star, Regulus, by the weekend and early the following week. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outer lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.